sexual harassment. In a series of tweets, Anurag rubbished these allegations. He asked why it took so long in this attempt to silence him. He also took a dig at Kangana, saying that she dragged several other women despite being a woman herself. He further added that this is just the beginning of a series of attacks against him. This comes after actor Payal Ghosh, in a tweet on Saturday, accused Kashyap of forcing himself on her. She also tagged PMO India for help and also cited a risk to her safety. After her tweet, while Kangana Ranaut backed Payal and demanded Anurag Kashyap's arrest, actress Tapsee Pannu tweeted in support of the filmmaker, calling him the biggest feminist she knows. Meanwhile, the National Commission for Women chief Rekha Sharma has asked Payal to file an official complaint to initiate action. So Anurag Kashyap has now lashed out at Payal Ghosh, in fact dismissing all these allegations, referring to them as unsubstantiated. He's in fact claimed that this is a conspiracy against him, questioning the timing of Payal Ghosh actually making these allegations. We spoke to actor and complainant Payal Ghosh. Listen in to what she had to say. Payal Ghosh, the actor who's leveled serious allegations against filmmaker Anurag Kashyap, is joining us here on India Today. Payal, I want you to first tell our viewers what exactly happened with Anurag Kashyap.
I went to meet him for the first time at his office in Aramnagar 2, then with my manager. Next day he called me and he said, "Are you around?" I said, "Yeah." He said, I said, "I'm in Lokhandwala." He said, "Then come down at my place." I went to his place. He gave me the address and everything. I went to his place and he was very sweet that day. He cooked food for me. He gave the plate and all this, you know. Like, he was very nice. He was talking about his struggle and about my thing. And he was talking about himself. And then he asked me that, "You tell me about yourself," and all. And everything was perfectly nice. And I was very impressed the first day I met him. And the second day again he called me, and when I went to him, we talked for a while, and after that he took me to another room, and then the experience that I have experienced was something very horrific, and I didn't expect that from him, and I was very shocked, and it haunted me till today. It's been 6 years, I think, almost.
So when did this happen?
But
this
it haunted me till 2020? Today. I tried to say it many times before also. 2014, that time he was shooting for Bombay Velvet, so it's somewhere there.
So you went to meet him for the film?
I went to meet him, not because of any particular project, but I'm not for the Bombay Velvet also. I just went to meet him just to meet for the sake of meeting him. Hmm. And then it was like a normal meeting, formal meeting. So next day he told me, "Come down and wear something that nobody should think that you are an actress. You should wear something very simple." So I went worn salwar kameez and went to meet him. That day he was fine, but next day when I again went to meet him, and he only called me, that time things what happened was not expected.
So Payal, if this happened in 2014, and this is a question that Anurag Kashyap also has asked in response to your allegations, why have you chosen to speak out now?
I tried to, you can go and see if you can retrieve my deleted tweet. I have tweeted so many times, but I was been forced by my family, by my friends, by my well-wishers from the industry to delete those tweets. And I have tweeted, and then many a times I have deleted those tweets. But I wanted to say this from long time before, and I really wanted to say this, but I couldn't got the support. And this time when I spoke, I didn't say it to anybody, I didn't share and didn't tell it to anybody that I'm going to talk about this. I kept quiet because I know if I would have said anybody, any of my friend or any people associated with me, and because they don't want me to get into controversies, they don't want me to, you know, they think that this can also ruin my Bollywood career. So they are very concerned and worried about that. And so, also I come from a very conservative family, and in my family, like, I fought with my family to come to this industry, and today when I speak about it, definitely, like, today then they will definitely say, "Well, we told you not to go into this industry."
So you're saying, Payal, you're saying that for 6 years you did speak out about this time and again?
Yes, I have said, and in 5-10 minutes my tweets got deleted by my friends, and you know, like, I have my people who looked after my Twitter, and they have deleted it immediately, saying that don't get into this controversy.
Because Anurag Kashyap, you know, when he's responded to you, Anurag Kashyap, when he's responded, has said that this is a conspiracy. Yeah. He's questioned the timing of these allegations against him. because, you know, he is saying that it's because of the stand he's taken against BJP, because of his fight with Kangana Ranaut, that now all of this is coming out.
I have nothing to do with BJP, I have nothing to do with Congress, I have nothing to do with any political party, I have nothing to do anything with anybody. And I have worked in South Film industry, I have worked in Bollywood as well, and I have never experienced this kind of horrific scenario ever in my life. This is the only time it happened, and I tried to speak about this many a time, but this time I felt that I should talk about it. And I got support from a friend from my Telugu channel, and he said, like, it is not about yourself, it's about other girls. If you'd have known how he is, you would have never gone and meet him, because you are not ready for that. But let other know also, and let them take the call. So I decided to speak upon it and come out and talk about it.
Okay.
Because I know if I say it, can to maybe whatever other girls can be benefited from this.
Okay, so you're saying you put out this message so that anyone associated with Anurag Kashyap knows what they're dealing with. But then, are you planning to take this forward? Now that you've spoken out, Payal, are you going to be approaching the police, ensuring you file that FIR also against Anurag Kashyap?
I haven't decided anything at the moment. I don't know. It all depends on the way my family will support and how they will take it. Upon then only I can take the decision. Right now I haven't taken any decision. I just wanted to tell people that the kind of mask they wear and talk about women liberation and patriarchy and all these things that they talk about, I just want to say that this is what they are in real. So
you don't want any action against them?
They don't have any rights to talk about something which they themselves don't follow.
I haven't decided anything
at the moment, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I haven't decided about anything at this moment. I don't know. I wanted to talk about this. I talked about this, and later I'll decide. Let me see what happens, because my family is also very angry on me, so I need to convince them first.
No, the reason I'm asking that question, Payal, just hold on. One more question. I also wanted to ask her about how she wants to take that forward and whether she is going to be approaching the police, but she's maintaining that at this point she's going to wait and see what happens. Allegations that she's leveled against Anurag Kashyap are very, very serious here. The filmmakers hit back saying this is a conspiracy. Payal is saying that after 6 years, she felt the need to speak out now.